Hey, gated horse riders, I have a question for you. Do you listen to your horse? This should be a quick video where I just want to talk about some things that really are important to me. One of those things is listening to your horse. And no, I don't mean that they're going to speak in English to you or send mental images to your head or anything like that. But horses communicate primarily by body language. That's right. So we know that, yet sometimes I think we are very quick to judge the horse on their actions, assigning human emotions or human intentions. That's actually called anthropomorphization. It's a big word, just means that we're assigning human emotions to animals. It's very easy to do. I find myself doing it. But one of the things that I try to watch for is, are the horses telling me something through their actions and their body language about what they need or what they feel that I'm ignoring? For example, I've had people tell me or ask, they come to me and they ask a question like, why did my horse start bucking? He does it sometimes and does it this or that. And so, you know, I'll ask, well, you know, does he like the saddle? Does it fit? I mean, all these different things. And they're like, oh no, it's all fine. And they pretty much assume that the problem is a behavior problem, that the horse is doing it to be bad. So if you're trying to saddle your horse and he won't stand still, or he's kind of fighting in the cross ties, you know, to me that says there could be a pain issue. It could be behavioral. Your horse could have learned to do that in the cross ties to get out of being saddled. But it isn't always. Sometimes it can be pain. It could be ulcers. They could have a problem with their teeth. They could have a problem with their back. And they could have a problem one day and not the rest of the time. If your horse doesn't want to stand for mounting, could it be a training issue? Of course it could. We've all had problems with our horse walking off. But could it be a pain issue? Your horse is anxious or nervous all of a sudden and it's not normal behavior. Could it be ulcers? Sure. And could your mare have some, could it be seasonal? Absolutely. But try to watch for these things. Try to be a little more empathetic with our animals than we sometimes are. I'm guilty of it as well, going out there and saying, I just want to ride today, and or I just need to get this done, and I'm just going to get on you and, you know, whatever. But try to pay attention for what's normal for your horse or what's abnormal for your horse, and don't just assume they do it to be bad. Don't just react negatively to some behavior, but think about what could be causing it. And you may be able to stop a problem before it gets too bad. There's times when I wish I would have paid more attention to what my animals or my horses were telling me, and I pushed right through it and didn't give them a chance to talk, and I regretted it later. So I'm not saying take that too far, and if your horse doesn't want to be ridden, don't ride them, but pay attention in case something deeper is actually causing your horse to behave this way, and it's not a behavioral problem. So again, just listen to your horse, pay attention to what's normal. You know your horse better than a vet, or better than your trainer, unless your trainer works with you a lot. So be aware of those things. Try not to put your horse in a situation that it's going to go bad, and part of that is just by you paying attention. Thank you so much for watching. If you have any questions, go ahead and comment below. You can go ahead and subscribe right here to get notified of all my other videos that are going to come out. Also, sign up my email list on my website. You'll get notified of other clinics and horses for sale and DVDs and things like that. So anyway, have a great day. Go have a fun ride.